When we actually get to rigging and building a skeleton and creating a hierarchy of joints and stuff like that, this outliner is going to start to get pretty crowded with things. So it's important to stay organized every step of the way. So first of all, it's a tiny thing. I'm just going to name this guy Dwarf Hero Model. And aside from the indicator that it's a mesh, I also have this suffix that describes this asset as a model. So when anyone sees this in engine or anywhere else after it's been exported or anything like that, they know that they can just search for model or Dwarf Hero Model, and it's just very easy to find. And your naming conventions may vary depending on the project. So this is just a very generic way to do it. This is just how I do it, and that should work out just fine. Now, the next thing that we can do is take a look at our model and see where he sits on the grid. So normally I like to see him sitting centered on this flat grid here. And to make sure that that's happening, we can go over here on the left in this panel chooser and select the four panel layout. And that way we can see this front and side view. So if you look closely here, you can see he's going a little bit into negative space here. It's not a big deal, but preferably I'd like to see him sitting exactly on that line. So I'm gonna hit W, and up here in the perspective view, I'm gonna just kind of scooch him up a little bit so he's resting about on that line there. Now for the side view, I'm looking at this up and down line here, and I want to place him so that he feels like his center of gravity is running straight through that center line. And that's just a more comfortable place for me to have him sitting, kind of so his weight balance is on this intersecting point right here. So I'm going to scooch him back a little bit until I feel like it looks right. And that looks pretty good right about there. It looks like if you were to stand on a point right there, he'd be able to balance if he was a very agile cat person. Now that the character is centered on the grid, we want to make sure that his pivot point is also centered on the grid. So you'll see right now that I have the W, the move tool, activated. You can see that he has a pivot point right in his crotch area here in his waist. And when we rotate him, we see that he rotates from that point. And that's not what we particularly want right now. We want the pivot point to be centered in 0, 0, 0 space on the grid, so in the center point here. And to do that, we need to move this pivot point without moving the model. So we're going to hold down the D key, and you'll notice when we do that, our widget changes shape. And that indicates that we can move it without moving anything else. So I'm going to scooch it right down. So it's about in the middle. And now to make perfectly sure that it's in the middle, I'm going to go up to the top here, and you'll see this row of magnets. And if you don't see it, you may have to collapse or retract some of these menus here. And the very first one with the little hashtag there, that's telling us that that's going to be snapping to the grid. And if you hold your mouse over it, you'll see snap to grid. So now, as we move, we snap to the grid, unlike before where we just move throughout 3D space freely. But we still want to move the pivot point, not the character. So we're going to do the same thing. We're going to hold D and drag until it snaps to that middle point. And it should be pretty obvious when you're resting in that middle point there. So I'm going to let go of D, I'm going to zoom out, and I'm going to say, wow, it looks great. He's right in the middle there. However, there's still one more thing that we need to check now that we've moved the pivot point around, and that's the transforms of this mesh. And to do that, we're going to look up in the top right corner for the show slash hide channel box button. We're going to click that so we can reveal the channel box. And this shows, if you don't already know, this will show all the transformations that you've done to the model or asset in the scene. So if I quickly rotate, you'll also notice in the channel box we get some rotation values. And those are cool because when we actually start animating stuff, we're going to be using these numbers in the graphic editor and in the animation tools in order to tell Maya where we're going to be placing these models. And so it's good to keep these nice and tidy. Like everything else, we're going to keep everything nice and clean. So you'll notice that because we moved the pivot point, we are seeing these new non-zero values in here. And that's not what we want. We want to see all these as zeros, and we want to see all the scales set to one. Everything should be in its default place there. So to take care of those values, we want to go up to Modify up here in the toolbar. Click that and look for Freeze Transformations. And when you click that, you'll notice Maya now associates this point in space as the 0, 0, 0 point relative to the model. So now when we move it, I'm going to unclick this lock to grid thing so we can have a smooth transformation. Now when we move it, We know we have translated this just about 40 units from the middle resting point where we placed the model. So if we ever wanted to put it back to normal, all we have to do is go back to zero instead of having to remember a weird number that we might have mistakenly left in there. So this is going to be crucial for later when we start making controllers for animation, because we want to be able to default these back to zero when we're done animating, or we want to go back to the bind pose. And we also want to make sure that we're working with very clean numbers. So all these are going to be kind of relative to this space that we've set up now. Nothing's going to get crazy far away from zero now that we've defaulted everything to zero. Not that we're going to be animating this mesh in particular. We just want to freeze it so that when we bring it into engines and stuff, no one is interpreting the numbers that we left behind as transformations in the engine. A lot of times if you leave funny numbers in there, you'll import your model and you'll realize, oh, he's been scooched because we left the weird number in there, even though in Maya he looked centered. So it's good to keep that clean as we move forward.